way. And Danny Frawley, you saw the pictures. He was up. He was vocal. He introduced those two players who were wearing the yellow and black, Guernsey and Stafford and Roden, for the first time. And a lot of Tiger history. I mean, those rooms down there aren't the greatest rooms in the AFL, but few have got more history.
Absolutely. And I noticed, Gary, while you were actually probably would have been making your way back up here after seeing Danny, I have seen that face before from very close quarters, and it's not a friendly one.
He means whacked business. It one time. You got 6 weeks.
Yeah, it was behind a whack coming the other way too. He was as tough as they come.
Didn't take long.
Josh Fraser coming to the bench, going to start on the interchange bench. We know McKee, a late withdrawal, Dermot, Stafford in the side, and also big Ottens for Richmond. It's going to be something that they have to keep an eye on very, very quickly.
They're going to have to monitor their bench. The kid who's running to the bench also, young Cole, he'll be actually in his first game of league footy, he's going to be pretty vital. They're going to need fresh, young legs with a lot of pace behind them. There we see the Richmond bench there with Rogers and Roden striding out there, or just stretching out.
Well, the Collingwood centre bounce will be Rocker, Buckley, Burns and Lucuria, the Copeland Trophy winner. And straight away, it's Cameron who goes to Buckley to tag. Clinton King's in the centre. Big Stafford will take the ruck work, and Campbell is the ruck rover to call the first action on AFL on 9. Dennis Cometti.
It's a new beginning. Umpires tonight, McLaren, Allen and Schmidt. And away we go. The season is officially underway. Stafford, a hand pass, still inside the centre square. But Theris goes off the ground, kicks it out wide. It tumbles down towards right half forward. Storming up the ground is Holland. Lays it off Lucuria. A natural left footer goes with the right. That's the result. Not a good kick. Gaspar works in front. Takes on the fence. And a boundary throw in.
Probably would have thought that Gaspar would go to Cummings, but Hall's got the job down there in the goal square, so just freed him up a bit.
And Bowden's picked up Buckley now as well, so a bit of a switch there. In the centre bouncer was Cameron, now it's Bowden, and now it's on as a show of strength early on.
Yeah, Dimatina is running with Tivendale and has not left his side from the minute this game started. That's the way he operates. Long night for Greg Tivendale. Interesting to see how he handles it.
Umpires tonight, Scott McLaren, Brett Allen and Justin Smith. And McLaren gives the first free kick of the night to the Tigers. This is Kellaway at halfback flank. Will chip kick inside. Holland glistening in the sunlight, in the lights tonight. Out to the wing position. Good body work there by Leon Davis. Magic, they call him, and the crowd roars for support. Here goes the kick up towards the Collingwood four forward zone. Richardson to the open goal. First blood to the Magpies. Goal to Collingwood. Beautiful play there by Leon Davis. It's on in the centre of the ground as Bowden has a go at Buckley. They race over to Leon, and Mark Richardson, the veteran of the Collingwood side, puts the first goal on the board in season 2002.
Well, watch the hit here from Leon Davis. That is, it came off the ground, but he's only a little fella. There was more danger to him than Joel Bowden, and that's one of those great aspects in league footy where you get a reward for a negative action, which, look, it's not really going to stand out on the scoreboard for Leon Davis, but he made the goal there. Well done, son.
Good positive reinforcement for him too, and a good result for Mark Richardson too. He's playing up forward opposed to Holland.
All about poise. Leon Davis looked up. He looked long and spotted a man deep. Great start for the Magpies. Early going at the MCG Thursday night football. Good bounce in the centre. Rocks go at it. On the way down, Rocker. His left hand slapped it out wide, pushing the back surely. Campbell gets the free kick. So important to the Tigers, the skipper breaks away. Lofts one inside the 50. A lot of jostling, hanging on. And Richardson was the man hung on to. Wakeland pleads his case. He wants a replay. Nothing doing. Richardson will kick a goal from 40 metres out.
Such a big man. And he initiates. Well, you heard it there. He initiates contact because he's very confident in his own strength. And he can run, so he's got the dual-edged sword there as a forward.
24 career goals against the Magpies, including two hauls of five in 96 and 97. Richardson from 48 metres out, so important to his early confidence. Sliding away to the right, did it brush the post? No!
Well, it is a great result for Matthew Richardson, and important, Dermot, from his point of view, that he can get one out with Wakeland. I mean, sides are so inclined to drop one back. Anthony Rocker was heading back there in this situation, but you see the attention that he attracts. I mean, that's a free kick, no question about it. Wakeland all over him, and That's a good result from him. Dennis mentioned it. Confidence for him, such a big thing.
Coming up to the four-minute mark of this first term, it's a goal apiece. Richmond and Collingwood back in the centre of the ground. It'll be Rocker up against Stafford. Rocker gets the tap. King had first hands on the ball. Now it's Buckley for his first possession. Just got the handball out to Lucuria. Quick kick with the left foot. It was fortuitous. And the mark's been taken by Rintoul. He'll kick from just inside 50 directly in front.
Good kick on the run. Not so sure about his set shot. Prowess.
Rintoul's kicked 30 goals, 35, Dermot, in 73 games of football after making his debut in 1997. So Rintoul for Collingwood's second score. It's on its way. It's good. It's a goal. The Magpies have got their second.
Well, every junior footballer around Australia would have had a coach say to them, play in front, son, and you'll get some opportunities that you may not otherwise get. And that was simply the case there. The clearance out of the centre, it wasn't pretty. The good players get their hands on it often enough. Buckley just forced it forward, and it was a scrubber of a kick from Lucuria. But that's the advantage. Chad Rintoul takes front spot, and things fall your way.
It's an amazing player, Nathan Buckley, isn't he? Look, there's no rhyme or reason in a football terminology why he should have got on the end of that ball, but he does. The good players just smell the ball and they find out where it's going.
Collingwood by 6 points. Straight kicking, the essence so far. Two plays, one. There's the bounce. Stafford and Rocker. This is Burns at their feet. Hurried kick. Gaspar comes back, made to earn it. Plays on immediately. Aided by the Shepherd, swings it out very wide. It pitches in no man's land. Well done by Houlihan, got it away. Rogers, Campbell under pressure, floats one very wide. It bounces just inside the field of play and trickles out.
Gasper got the job on Tarrant, so obviously rated highly. Tarrant trying to keep Gasper wide, but he's a smart player, Gasper, knows the angles and was able to get inside him.
You can see Knights just coming on for his first run for the Tigers tonight.
Interesting, that matchup you were talking about, Gary. He took only 3 marks against Richmond in 2 games last year, Chris Tarrant. Dimatina out of defence, up towards the wing. There's that matchup again. They battle man on man. Tarrant, harassed, goes to ground. Lucuria falling to the ground. Johnson with nowhere to go. Out of bounds, boundary throw into the Magpies up by 6 points.
Pulling a few tricks, the Pies already. They've pushed Nathan Buckley forward. And he's about 50 metres to the left-hand side of screen. He's taken Joel Bowden away from the middle here.
Yorra's just snuck out the back for the Tigers. Leon Davis and a mismatch up forward, and here it comes as Houlihan has a bounce and runs to centre wing. The lead comes from Zilla. Decides not to worry about it. Now he goes looking for Ottens. Oh. Ottens has got the set and the mark. Beautiful mark. Good play by Houlihan. Held his kick, waited until Ottens ran to the goal square, and he was too tall and too good for Presta Giacomo. He'll line up 15 metres out directly in front.
And I'll go, Adam Houlihan is a super intelligent footy player because he did have the poise to hang on to the ball. He knew that he made Brad Ottens run back the goal, Dermot, by carrying it that extra 5 metres. Ottens led short and said, no, he's not going to kick it. That means he's got some time, and almost forced him back.
Brad Ottens for his 100th goal in football. He's kicked 99 goals, 50 in 79 games of football. This is his 80th game. This will be his 100th to make scores level at the 7.5 minute mark of the opening term. He comes in and puts it through, scores a level at the MCG.
Well, the interesting thing there about Brad Ottens, I mean, most forwards can come up and meet the ball. So a Stewie Lowe type player comes up and meets the ball. And someone like a Houlihan, Paul Hudson type player is very good running back with the flight of the ball. When you've got a big man who can come up and meet it and run back with the flight of it, which is harder for a big man to do, which you saw Brad Ottens do there, that is an exceptionally dangerous forward to mind. And he is going to be a handful.
Fair grab too.
Wonderful kick, wonderful mark. Big crowd at the MCG, 65, 70,000. Kicking off the 2002 footy season. Play restarts, Stafford comes with the run. Beaten again by Rocker. Buckley breaks away, kicks down towards half forward. Waiting behind Davis, had it bounce off his chest. He's right on the 50, feeds it out wide. Some hesitation, but there is now back to goal. With some time and space, settles 52 metres out, pulls it back towards the middle. Richardson in front, Dimatina, interesting. Zilla goes to ground. Cameron stood his ground, got the hand pass away. Loose ball, a chance for the Tigers under extreme pressure. Down went Knights. Tawny hits for the boundary line. Whistle on play. It's coming back. A free kick to Richmond. No advantage there. It'll come to Knights.
Tio thought Brody Holland was scragged when he went for the mark earlier. Taken with the flight of the ball there. Bit fortunate there for the Tiger defenders.
So Knights wobbles one out, but good enough to Stafford for his first kick for the Tigers. The former Sydney Swan, originally from Lane Cove up in Sydney. A big Stafford. Fraser on for Collingwood. Rocker off for a breather. Both suffering from osteitis pubis over the summer.
Good player, this fella.
So Stafford with Fraser on the mark. Comes in. Hoiks it up in the air. Looking for Campbell, who flies unattended and takes the mark. Read it better. Got in front of Lucuria.
Poor result for Collingwood, Eddie. They should have done better than that.
Campbell kicks up, looking for Houlihan. Kept his eyes on the ball. Got a free kick. It'll go the way of the Tigers.
They are determined to keep Brad Ottens close to goal, which is a bonus, of course, because of how dangerous he is.
Gasper.
Look at this. Gasper's been left on his own. Tarrant was zoning off, but Gasper had far too much latitude there. Little chip over the top from Houlihan, and Gasper lines up. Free kicks, Richmond 5, Collingwood yet to record one as Gasper lines up for goal.
If you were a high supporter hoping for a miss here and you had to pick a Richmond player to have the ball, having a set shot.
Darren Gasper, 32 metres out from the man on the mark. The angle is 54 degrees. The AFL average from this position is only 54%. He's kicked 13-8 in his career. He comes in, and you wouldn't believe it, he puts it right through the middle for the Tigers. And Richmond go to the front by a goal.
Now that's one of the other reasons that Darren Gasper has been chosen to play on Chris Tarrant, is because he does run and will back himself and is prepared to get down inside his forward 50. And if Chris Tarrant, I'm not saying he won't chase him, but if he doesn't concentrate for the whole period of time, then he'll get hurt like this. Tarrant was just out of picture. There he is there. He's only 10 or 15 metres away. No excuse. You go to your opponent. Cover your man. And copybook kicking style, Dermot. Textbook.
You'll enjoy telling the forwards about that one, Darren Gaspar. The margin is 6 points. Tigers on top for the first time. Play restarts. Collingwood generally have done well inside the centre square. Campbell going nowhere. Immediately drew a crowd as we go down to the dock.
Yeah, it's Leon Cameron, interesting, just having his jaw and teeth checked a minute ago. Took a very heavy hit onto the jaw. They were just excluding that he hadn't cracked the jaw, but he's a bit sore, but he's still out there.
Another bounce alongside the centre circle. Stafford locks up with Fraser. No decision from the umpire. Laid down into the path of King with ample time. Interesting kick, though. Showed plenty of it to Tarrant. Tarrant still going, crowd wanting a free kick, aided by a Shepherd. Tarrant lays it off. This is Burns, needs to kick and does. Probing kick inside the 50. Richardson, Fiora leads back in the race. Deep in the back pocket, a natural left footer. He sold himself into trouble here. Goes by hand, while they get away with it. This is Houlihan, took it from Tawny. Kicks towards midfield, low down the tumbling mark. Is taken by Stafford. Tigers on top by 6 points. Stafford running 50, nothing doing. Fraser stands the mark. Breaking hard, Tivendale into space. Wheels around onto that left foot. Well worked out by Knights on the mark, and the mark is taken by Richardson. Hits the ground, fires a goal, and he's got it. Well worked by the Tigers. That was very clever, particularly the blocking by Knights on the man on the mark, enabling Tivendale to cut away to his left side.
I'll tell you what, you go into this game when you see McKee's out and Fraser's had an injury interrupted preparation, and you know that Richmond are the best contested mark team in the competition. Well, marks at this stage of the game, 10 to Richmond and 2 to Collingwood. They are dominating the air. Ottens, Richardson and Stafford looking extremely dangerous.
That was great sight on vision there, wasn't it? I mean, sometimes when the ball's coming in relatively flat and you're caught behind your opponent, you panic and you might try and put a boot in his back to shove him forward or something like that. Richardson read the flight of the ball perfectly.
Richardson, Ottens and Gasper, the goal kickers. Rich has had two and all over 6 foot three, boys, in the old scale. Out of the centre break, it was Burns who marked for Collingwood to Freeborn, who goes to the outer side. It's a wobbly old kick. Clement has got the job ahead of him. It bounces nicely for him, though. Usually a good disposal. Clement hits Betheris on the chest at half forward. kept running, did Clement. He kicks inside 50. Holland's the man who needs the mark. Got his hands to it, couldn't hold it. Down to Chadron Tool. A high up and under towards the goal square. Tarkenlock is the only man there for Collingwood. He brought it to ground. Here's Brodie Holland trying to crash through. He's tackled high. No, says the umpire. Play on as Gasper goes backwards to Cameron. The pressure is enormous down there, and Knights concedes the behind, the first of the night. It's Collingwood 2-1, 13. Richmond 4 goals straight, 24. It's the Tigers by 11 points. We've played 14 minutes opening term.
Been composed in the back half. Richmond, Fiora, I like the look of Fiora down there, Dermot. He just backs himself. He's got good leg speed.
Playing on Leon Davis at the moment. That's what's ahead of him, Leon Cameron. Most times, his safety kick is to the left-hand side of screen here, short and left, predominantly for the Tigers.
Told to hurry up. Ignores the advice from Dermot and drives it out wide towards the outer side. Richardson, soccer's off the ground, back inside the 50. Tawney with dash, did nicely. This is Hall, agile for a big man, to Tawney again. Awkward kick, King at half-back, sends play back towards the outer side wing. Going with the flight of the ball, Ottens. The two Tigers stayed on their feet. Surely Knights was taken high. Play on's the call, and the ball's out of bounds. Well, either one thing or the other, one would have thought. Holding the ball or a high tackle.
Now, I think on reflection of that one there, Dennis, he really did duck his head.
And that was the indication from the umpire too, Dermot. So, good decision, I reckon.
Well, we may debate that. Tossed it on the outer side. Ottens. Burns fell over. Lucuria, good shepherd. The theorist was the shepherder. Lucuria took a while to pick it up. Burns stays off the ball. The theorist feeds it forward. Richardson kicks inside the 50. And Scott Cummings on the burst. Takes the mark 35 metres out directly in front.
Not sure Scott Cummings could play any other position on the ground, Dermot, but he knows how to play full forward and times his lead so very well. You only need to be quick over 10 yards as a full forward. And if you can read what's happening upfield, your chance to get on the end of it.
Good kick too, wasn't it? It didn't give, it was right in the channel. There was no loft on it. And he just kept sprinting out and trusted the disposer to hit him lace out.
Coleman medalist back in 1999. Should kick this. Margin currently 11 points. It's now 5.
Well, they'll be hoping for a return of something in the order of 50, I would think. 50 plus from Scott Cummings if he's able to play 20 games. And he needs to be kicking goals, no question about that. But it was a good setup. Richardson used the ball really well.
He's a good kick, Big Richo. He's a beautiful kick. He's got an awkward drop with two hands. You watch him on the end of this. He rarely misses. And a lot of people, because they've got Rocker in the team and those types of blokes, he loses a lot of that highlight aspect of how far he can kick it.
Back at the MCG, Scott Cummings with his first kick for Collingwood. Kicks a goal, 3-1, 19 to 4 goals straight, 24. It's the Tigers by 5 points at the 17-minute mark of this opening term. Rocker back on, Fraser off for Collingwood, and Rocker gets the tap down to Lucuria. The Copeland Trophy winner with his fifth disposal kicks it to the forward 50. They all ran underneath it. It was Cameron at the back for the Tigers. Holland rode the bump beautifully for Collingwood. Conceded ground. Back it goes to Tarrant. Tarrant looks up. It's a high up and under. No one to mark this one. Up goes Buckley. Fall of the ball. The Tigers get it. Out to the wing. It's 3-on-1. Prestigiacomo stands underneath King and takes a strong mark. Handball straight away to Burns. Could have put his teammate under pressure, but Burns had enough poise to find Clement in the middle of the MCG. Clement looks up. Only one player to hit, and he does. And that's his former West Australian mate in Chad Rintoul. Rintoul quickly up forward. Out came Cummings. It was punched away by Ray Hall, and the Tigers clear.
Ball around the outer side. Richo, how will it bounce? Awkwardly, had to wait. Wakeland got him. Crowd, rock ball. Boundary throw in.
Not as quick as he used to be, Matty Richardson. Two or three years ago, he'd have left Wakeland in his wake. But he just didn't cover the ground all that quick. Got to say, too, that Chris Tarrant is just out of sorts at the moment. He's not finding it.
Richardson from behind. Richardson, take your pick. It was won by Richardson. Knocked out of there by Rogers. Burns did well, looking for Richardson. Whistle. Free kick to the Tigers. Out of the top four.
Clinton King now. Clinton King.
That makes 10 to 4 in favour of the Tigers in free kicks.
Gee. Interesting one. No. This is Holland.
Come on. 2 minutes. Keep coming.
voice of Scott McLaren.
Look at this cracker.
40 metres out.
And that is the advantage of having two dangerous forwards like Richardson and Ottens, because they just demand so much respect. The Collingwood backline tend to gravitate towards those two big players, and smart players with good vision then say, what other options have I got? And Andrew Cracker's got to be confident enough to present himself and get on the end of it.
I might have to turn the lights up over my desk here. It's 10-4 inside, 56 zip in favour of Richmond free kicks.
Likes to work it right to left, starts it out to the right, it's bending back, not enough. So the first blemish for the Tigers, 4-1 plays 3-1.
A young Andrew Cracker with his first kick, just missing. Buckley from fullback for Collingwood. Good zone set up by Richmond. Getting away was Johnson. It was a dodgy one. It was intercepted beautifully by Richardson over the top to Rogers. His kick was smothered by Prestigio Giacomo. A little bit of cracker magic in there. Opened up where there was no room at all. Here's the Tigers. They've got a chance again. But Clement goes in for Collingwood. Betheris thumps it wide, but it's going to come straight back. Richo again. Outside the 50-metre arc. Looking for the handball off. The left-footed Knights. Looks up forward and look at that. Cracker's all on his own again. He takes the mark of the lineup. 55 metres out on a 45.
Well, just too much time there for Matty Knights. He just measured that perfectly. And if we just went back a little bit, I had a look at the Collingwood kick in there. They have a secondary huddle. The Collingwood boys, when they kick the ball in after a point, at centre half forward, 100 metres away, they have six men huddle. Used to be the huddle used to occur at centre half back. Let's have a look at this angle here. And he should have gone to school on the last one. He didn't hit it properly. If he hits this right, it's through.
So the reverse angle here as Andrew Cracker comes in to the city end. He bends it right through the middle this time. Right under Andrew Cracker, his first goal in football, and the Tigers pull away.
Good signs that their forwards are getting involved early, Dermot. They've got goals now to Ottens, Richardson and Cracker. And again, when you, as you said, if you give someone as much time as Matthew Knights has with that left foot of his, I mean, they're lining up there. Tivendale also pushed into the hole. So a number of different options going forward from a Richmond point of view presents plenty of problems for Collingwood.
Cracker's first goal. Goes without saying, Collingwood need the next one. 5-1 plays 3-1, but the signs aren't good. Tigers getting free inside their 50. They're looking ominous. Ottens goes up, directs it down, follows through, dragged off it, held a long time in the tackle. Dimitina slides in, going nowhere, and the umpire wants it.
The centre breaks are well and truly going in favour of the Pies at the moment. So that's one thing they've got happening for them. If they can capitalise on that and at least put some pressure on the other end.
Ottens waits, Rocker collides with him, knocked down by King. Interesting kick from Tarrant, helped on its way by Dimitina down towards half forward. Holland concedes some ground, plenty of height on it, tawny aided by a good shepherd, kicks down towards half forward. Danger again, Collingwood in trouble, 2-on-1. Matthew Knights, they're queuing up in the middle.
Vision.
Buttons has got it, 30 metres out.
Matthew Knights, I mean, took a bit of a risk by, when there was a bit of a stop play in the middle of the ground, he pushed forward. Tark and Lockyer also took a bit of a risk and said, well, whoever wins the ball, he's going to find himself in space. It went Richmond's way. Knights was in space, probably 30 metres on his own. And as I said earlier, you give him time and room, he will inevitably hit a target.
Ugh. He actually miskicked that. Still almost, you would say it was just about laced out. Let's have a look at Brad Otten's beautiful kick here. 29 metres out, 2-degree angle. AFL average 84, his probability 94% of kicking this.
Beautiful off the boot. Well, Knights had a buffet and the feast went to Ottens, and the Tiger faithful really enjoying that. Suddenly they're out by 3 goals.
I would have thought the 94% probability was actually insulting to Brad Ottens on that occasion. He's never going to miss from there.
No, he's a beautiful kick of the football, but they've got a few decisions to make in the centre square here, Collingwood, I think. Buckley, who hasn't had the work put into him over the summer that probably he would like, is spending a lot of time forward, which leaves Lockyer to shoulder a fair bit of the load. And at the moment, he has had his work cut out.
So Brad Ottens has kicked 2 goals. This young star from Tigerland. Ball up in the centre of the ground. The Tigers by 3. 6 minutes to go in the quarter. Ottens gets the tap. It spills out to Buckley. Quick boot up towards the forward 50. Richardson for Collingwood. Got his hand on the ball. Spills out. Gasper. Oh. Threw that one out. Got away with it. Ball comes out wide. Here's Hilton. Zoned off by Presta Giacomo, but his kick away. It might rebound. No, umpire's picked out a free kick to the Tigers. And Rogers gets a free kick on centre wing. They're all running. The Tigers, yellow and black. Wave after wave down forward. The mark's taken by Tivendale. Wheels around onto the left foot and thumps it long to the goal square. Up they go. Big pack flies. Rocker's there. Cracker crashes through for the Tigers. Rocker on top of him. And we'll have a ball up.
Andy Cracker, he's not a star yet. And he might never become one, but he's definitely got something. He almost glued that in the left hand as he ran past that. That's the top five possession getters. And no surprise that three of them are Tigers.
A Cracker, who kicked three goals last year from his three games. He's kicked 1-1 in season 2002. Over the top it goes, as easy as you like. Richardson puts it through for another goal to the Tigers.
Gee, you just got to wonder, don't you? Wakeland on Richardson there at a ball up. It's, 12 metres out from goal. He's already kicked a couple. You've got to touch and feel these blokes.
Can Stargo, Shane Wakeland.
Well, let's have a look at
ball.
This. Watch Richardson just drop out the back here. Wakeland goes to the pack. You just can't afford to do that in that situation. Mick Mouldhouse would be filthy with that. And he's played enough footy, Wakeland, to know better.
Yeah, that was great vision there. It showed Wakeland watch the ball, nothing but the ball, and gravitate towards it.
Two possessions for Joel Bowden. The second, very telling, that hand pass to Richardson in the goal square.
Six touches for Richardson, two marks, three goals. A fair opening quarter.
7-1 plays 3-1. Umpire very deliberate. Eventually we get the bounce. Ottens beaten by Rocker. Lockyer, Presta Giacomo, hooks it down towards half forward, working in front, Fiora juggles the mark. Everything falling into place for the Tigers. Fiora, the youngster across half back, pulls the kick slightly, setting it up for Ottens, the big man, who is checked in his approach to the ball by Dimatina. He's a bit stiff there. Dimatina had no thought of playing the ball. This is Tarrant inside the centre square, but the ball must come back.
Collingwood crowd cheering the free kick, the first for the night there. 7-1 the freeze.
Off his step. Well, lazy football. Campbell steps around the magpie. Kicks inside the 50. Houlihan, unkind bounce. Well, I spoke too soon. It came back to him. Touched off the boot. Down towards full forward. Wakeland goes down. Hit solidly by Rogers. Cracker went in solidly. Presta Giacomo under pressure.
He's
swings
hurt.
It out wide. Chance for Collingwood.
Wakeland's down behind play.
That was Wakeland. Still on the ground. The trainers are out there now. Meantime, Buckley has it close to the boundary line out of side. Wakeland on his knees. 43 plays 19. Lucuria back towards the middle. Spots Richardson. Cracker got there in time.
Travel.
Knocked it
travel away.
Tivendale nicely done. Campbell feigns a hand. Kicks inside the 50. Well, Richardson, his man coming up the ground in the hands of a trainer, will line up at his fourth goal.
Dennis, you'd also have to ask a question now of some of the smaller Collingwood backs who saw that Wakeland was down for probably 20 seconds. There's the incident. Good hit and shoulder by Rogers. The most dangerous player on the ground at the moment is Wakeland's opponent. That's where awareness comes into it. You have to be screaming at someone to come back and grab Richardson at some stage. He's the last bloke on the footy field who you want standing on his own.
Well, he's firing at his fourth. A clash of heads between Matthew Rogers and Wakeland. Richardson, meantime, his confidence soaring, and so is the Tigers' score.
That was a decent hit on Shane Wakeland. Incidentally, he was led over the ball and both boys were going for it. Bowden just got the point of the shoulder on the side of his head there. You have a look at it. You called danger, danger when that was happening there, Gary. It was a little bit like lost in space. And they
fire were.
The Tigers were lost in space. They had plenty of it out there. And, yep, we kicked pretty freely there, Matty Richardson.
Might be a blessing. Richardson now under Richardson.
Welcome back, and the Tigers are 5 goals clear with 3 minutes to go in this first term. Mark Richardson has gone down onto Matthew Richardson, who has taken the Collingwood defence apart. Let's go to the Doc quickly. Doc, what's happening with Shane Wakeland?
Yeah, Shane Wakeland talking to Dr. Paul Blackman at the moment, Eddie. Just a bit concussed, a little bit fuzzy in the head. He should be a bit right in a few minutes, I think.
All right. In the meantime, James Clement gets the ball going. Collingwood suddenly have some numbers up forward. It comes to Buckley at half forward. Out comes Cummings. Buckley hits him on the chest. Cummings lining up 45 metres out, and boy, do the Maggies need this one.
I saw Ray Hall there just sit off the back of him, and he looked up the field and he saw Nathan Buckley. Right about now, Ray Hall's thinking, this is Buckley, he can kick long, and he just peeled off for the long one, the long shot at goal. But Scotty Cummings, such a beautiful timer of leads, Buckley thought that's going nowhere except straight through the channel to Scotty Cummings' chest.
Cummings has kicked one, a 79% probability over the last 4 years for Scott Cummings from this spot on the ground. He comes in, he bends it back, and the Magpies get one back and trail by 4 goals at the 29 and a half minute mark of this opening term. A badly needed goal for the Magpies, and Scott Cummings does what he's paid for to do, and that's kick goals.
Now, what the Pies are doing, yes, they've got four men close to goal in this setup at the centre bounce. They play two secondary type centre half forwards out on the point of the square, and hopefully they get a centre man break, now centre bounce break, and go deep. It's not working. It's getting repelled all the time. Richmond are playing to the inside of their opponents. Get into that ball first. So Collingwood are getting the quick breaks out of the centre, but being turned backwards when it goes there.
2 minutes to quarter time. Margin 24 points. 8-1 plays 4-1. Ottens has to wait. Rocker came over the top. Tarrant lays it off. This is Scotland. Chips it out wide. Close checking down there, so the Tigers knock it away. Zilla, the beneficiary of the crumb, went to ground. Scotland again. Tarrant, forward of the wing, surveys the options, shows the third of two, went to Rogers. This is Bowden, who's been quiet, throws it on the boot. It goes out wide towards the wing. Hilton, metres behind his man, Buckley. Buckley closing quickly, forced him across the line. Well done by the champ.
They are taking a bit of a risk, Richmond, at times. They are prepared to push forward. Clearances.
Clangers, in fact, 10-2 against Collingwood there. So the Magpies getting plenty of it and turning it over, Gary.
Hardly a surprise. Lucuria in trouble. King taken high. He'll get the free kick, and the crowd won't like that.
This is where Richmond are most dangerous. They're working really hard at keeping plenty of room around Richardson and Ottens in these situations.
Clinton King from centre wing. Once again, Tigers up forward have got plenty of numbers and no Magpies near them. It's Tivendale on the boundary line. Little chip kick forward, looking for Ottens. Up they go, front and square. Tigers got plenty of players there. Campbell's one of them. It spills out to Rogers. Kicks with his right. It's a high up and under to the goal square. Ottens is the man. Richardson's the man there. Over his head and through for a behind. So the Tigers are 8 goals to 50. Richmond are 4-1-25. It's 25 points of difference. And as you can see there, 58 seconds to go in the first term.
Just saw Richo grimacing. He's on 16 goal pace at the moment. 6-2 has become 7-2, has become 8-2. It's just blowing out. And the margin 50 to 25. So double in the pocket, Dimatina.
The bad news here too is in the Wizard Cup, if that's anything to go by, Collingwood get worse as the game goes on, and Richmond have been getting better.
Josh Fraser up towards half back. Little chip pass, forced to go wide. Buckley out against the boundary line, sends it up towards the wing. Richardson the target. Holland waiting behind. Swings the hand pass wide. King had stayed off the pack. Fiora comes across the ground. Rogers. Can they get their ninth? Rogers finds Tawney pushing up the ground. Tawney forward of right centre wing. Cracker comes on the lead. It goes in that direction. Didn't hang on. Found it on the ground. Lays it off. Rogers a thumping kick normally. Not his best effort. It wanders down towards the pocket. Taken by Tivendale. That is far too easy.
Well, just before, prior to the ball getting down there, Dennis, I mean, Richmond again had two and three players running inside 50 without an opponent anywhere near them. And with 2 seconds to go, it's the last thing they wanted. Rogers has been outstanding, had 8 touches for the first quarter.
Off the bench too, still got 8 possessions.
And it's just snuck up on you. This is a 9-goal quarter, Dermot. And it really didn't blow it away until probably halfway through it.
They kicked 50% of their score in time on the Tigers. in the Wizard Cup, so, and they're proving to do the same again. They're blowing them away here. 13 goals in an opening quarter of league footy for 2002. At least there's got a bit of excitement
it's
out there,
it's loose, that's what it is.
So Tivendale's fitness, he just got away from Dimatina, and the Tigers got one with 2 seconds to go. And they lead by 31 points at quarter time in the opening stanza of season 2002. It's been an absolute beauty for the Tigers. 9 goals to 56, Collingwood 4-1-25. The goal kickers for Richmond, Matthew Richardson has kicked 4 goals, and singles to Tivendale, Andrew Cracker, Brad Ottens and Darren Gasper up from the back pocket to kick one as well. For Collingwood, Scott Cummings has kicked 2 goals, Chad Rintoul 1 and Mark Richardson 1 as well. Danny Frawley comes out to be happy with his work so far. The Tigers have beaten Collingwood 8 out of their last 10 starts. It's Richmond 9-2-56, Collingwood 4-1-25. And the Magpies have got plenty to do in the next 3 quarters of football. And if you reckon football's not tough, have a look at this.
as I've seen her and see her is truly.
Welcome back to the MCG. Around 70,000 people here, and that score is a record. First quarter score for Richmond against Collingwood. Their best ever before was 7-3-45 in 1963, round one at Punt Road. Well, they've done better than that tonight by a long way. 9-2-56 to Collingwood's 4-1-25. 13 goals for the quarter being scored, with Matthew Richardson scoring four of them. Let's go to Gary Lyon and Dermot Brereton for a look at the stats.
Yeah, I think centre breaks, Dermot, in favour of Collingwood. Now, what that says, I think, that perhaps their structure up forward isn't great, because they've also gone inside 50 on a similar number of occasions.
10-11 in favour of the Tigers. So only one the difference there.
And marks, 23 to Richmond, 16 to Collingwood. It's where they're marking them as well. They look far more dangerous.
All right, let's go down to Tony Jones, boundary side.
Well, actually, right in the middle of the ground, Ed, so we'll have to be quick here. Mick Malthouse certainly laying down the law to his players. That brittle back line was given special attention, and those turnovers you spoke about are a real worry.
OK, Tony Jones there. He's about to look at Tony Gay sprinting off the field, looking magnificent. I tell you what, he's a Collingwood supporter too, Tony. We won't have to put him in the back pocket the way things are going at the moment.
He might get a shot on Richo, because he's got his third at the moment. He's got Presta Giacomo, who's gone to him, and good luck, I'd say, at the form he's in.
All right, let's go down quickly to Doc Larkins as we start the second quarter with the Tigers leading by 31 points. Doc.
Yeah, Eddie, Shane Wakeland didn't leave the bench at three-quarter time. Still got mild concussion, so they're going to have to observe him, but they may not get him back tonight. Back to you, Eddie.
Dennis Cometti with the second quarter for AFL on Nine.
Scotland in trouble. Stafford's hand pass going nowhere. And there's our scoreline starting the second term. That first quarter, 9-2 by the Tigers. Their best first quarter ever against Collingwood. The previous best, 45. Back in 1963 at Punt Road. There's the bounce. Stafford thumps it towards half forward. Lucuria goes back. Ignored the ball, Cracker didn't. And again, a whistle and the ball up closer to the Tigers' goal.
Umpires mic'd up for the first time in senior football.
Come straight back out. Bouncing in front. Give us plenty of room.
Justin Smith laying down the law, saying get out of the way. They do so. Buckley does the ruck work against Stafford. Buckley does all the work against Richmond, but it's Knights who grabs the ball. Stafford gets the good handball out. Here's Bowden on his favourite left foot. He puts it out in front, and Richo takes the mark again. He's kicked four, and will line up from about 40 metres out at a stretch. Make that 45 now as the umpire places the mark. And Richardson is having a birthday out there on the MCG tonight.
I'm staggered that Stephen McKee isn't in the team. And perhaps he does have a niggle we don't really know about, because they are one ruckman short, the Pies. You saw Nathan Buckley have to go up for that contested tap out. Now, sometimes that happens just because you're there and the ball bounces that way, but he was the tallest bloke.
Well, the reason it was because Anthony Rocker dropped back into the hole. Now, there's a less than 50% chance from here, Matthew Richardson, which probably might even flatter him, Dermot.
Except he's hot tonight. Don't worry about that. Richo lines up for goal for the Tigers' 10th. From just inside 50, pushes it to the right-hand side. Up they go. Otten's almost took the mark. Now it spills over the line and out of bounds. Well, but throw in.
Danger zone
deep
here.
In the forward line. And Dermot, you said danger zone, because this is like a centering kick sometimes, the throw in from this position.
Absolutely. It almost, it's only about 5 metres from there. You'll see it there. Look where
there's
their
space. Form. Space.
Yep. Watch the back of it.
Plenty of space, goal side. Throwing in. Rocker, clean possession. Wrestle to the ground. Houlihan battling with his teammate. That was Bowden. Rocker in trouble. Tippendale going nowhere. Buckley had the footy, lost it. Rocker somehow got the ball to support Scotland. Nicely done. Well, chips the ball. Lockyer. Lucuria, a peek in the rear vision mirror. Now he breaks away. Around the outer side he goes. A couple of bounces. Probing kick down towards half forward. But Theorist going back with a flight of the ball. Showed courage. Hit the ground running. Gets the hand pass away. Well, he's not too dexterous down there, is Scotty Cummings. Not the place to hand pass at his feet.
Little suggestion there from Scotty.
I tell you, Greg Stafford is having a big say in this game. He's been terrific and worked super hard back into the hole in that situation. Didn't get a stat, but he's a big figure.
Well, in fairness to Bathurus, Cameron got a hand on that. Scotty trying to milk a free kick.
Oh, no.
Campbell to the groans of Dermot Brereton. Hand passes in front of himself, but Collingwood have got the numbers around the footy. This is Davis.
Hold on.
Working towards the boundary, pulls back towards the middle, accelerates away, kicks inside the 50, but straight to a Tiger. Tawney coming up for his eighth possession. He's been very good.
So Tawney deep in defence. And once again, plenty of Tigers on offer. Stafford takes the mark. Defensive 60 on halfback flank. Calls for Richo to run. Puts it out in front of him. Presta Giacomo goes with him, but Richo's too good. Kick was a beauty, wasn't it?
A 6 foot seven ruckman. He's put that lace out.
Richardson bombs it up. Richardson for Collingwood thumps it away, but the umpire's picked out a Tiger free kick and called play on. Tippendale's called to go on again into an open goal, and it's another one of the Tigers.
Get the feeling that Greg Tippendale was about the only bloke penalised on that occasion, because he won it at full burst. And nobody else really stopped. The first player to stop on play was Tivendar when he was about 20 metres down the line. You see, they've all chased him there, and Scotty Freeborn, he's led him through the gap there. He didn't even try and lay a tackle then. He was trying to go the umpire's way and suck him in. Keep playing the ball.
62 players, 25, early going second term from the MCG Thursday night football season's opener. Got the Tigers and the Magpies. Well, at the moment, just the Tigers. Rucks go at it, slapped forward by Stafford, chopped off. The high ball from Clement floats down towards half forward. Awkward bouncing ball. Davis under no pressure. Rintoul 55 metres out, chips for space. Cummings certainly their best forward, the most dangerous player deep in attack. He's taken this mark. It's about 35 metres out, 45 degree angle, and normally a very good kick.
Now, I know in history would show that I've been pretty critical of Anthony Rocker in the way he plays the game, and he hasn't got much base fitness, but he's just walked out of the centre square now to the left of screen. They need him to stand up.
Scott Cummings, his best efforts against Richmond, 4 for Port Adelaide, 3 for the West Coast Eagles, and 6 for Essendon. Going at his third right here, and my word, he's got it.
Kick.
Well, they've been a bit of trouble without Scotty Cummings. I mean, he looks to be the only one who seems to be dangerous up there. And this is at the situation, because when I looked at that Collingwood forward line, it doesn't really inspire me. So from a Richmond point of view, now's when you take a bit of a chance. If you're on an opponent who you think's not super dangerous down there, we'd start to edge your way over towards Scotty Cummings, because they will be very much Scotty Cummings' focus from this point on, I would imagine.
Having to lead out wide too, because there's a lot of numbers in the Collingwood forward line. Richmond just pushing back there. Plenty of time, because Collingwood are just labouring it forward.
Collingwood 31, Richmond double the score at 62. It's 10-2 to 5-1. Centre of the ground, Rocker got the tap. Here's Lucuria. Gets the handball to Buckley. Buckley quickly to Johnson. Left foot. Had the blinkers on, was caught from behind. Here's Tivendale quickly onto the boot. Heads to the boundary line. There's another free kick going the way of the Tigers, is it? It's coming back to Cracker for being held.
I think it was a tackle on Fraser. Just got a hand to him before Fraser kicked the footy.
No, he's given it for dropping the ball. Yeah.
That's hard.
Actually, Steph. Johnson it was, sorry.
Yep. So Cracker gets the free kick. He goes inside 50. Ottens was the target. Clement's gone back on him. This time Johnson gets it away to Buckley. Buckley to centre wing. Leon Davis back on the ground. Had to sit and wait. Good play there from Fiora for the Tigers. It knocks out to Davis. Going one-handed. It comes out to Cracker. Cracker finds some space. His kick was a bad one. That was chopped off by Holland at centre halfback. Wide he comes to the members' side. Here's Nicky Davis. Davis looks up. Tarrant's the lead. Tarrant keeps running. Gets to the ball. Has to turn inside. Leon Davis kept going. A bit of magic required for the Magpies. Tight to the boundary line. He kicks it out of bounds on the full into the second row, into the 20th row. And it's over the line out of bounds. The Tigers will relieve from the back pocket.
He just kicked the wrong side of the ball then. The idea was right, and he was going to lay it across the body, but he just got the wrong side of the ball. He was travelling too quick.
Only 70-odd thousand metres.
Now, I usually with Leon, if he's in front or on the boundary line, have a shot.
Good on him.
And he will.
This is Kellaway, left up back. Sends play up towards the wing, but Theorist came hard, got a fist on it. Oh, very clever. Campbell to Tivendale. He runs down towards the 50. There's a troop of them down there. There's some shepherding. It's allowed to go. So Tivendale could get his second goal as easy as you like. In fact, that's 3. His second in the space of a minute.
Well, Greg Tivendale had the, I suppose, the honour of one of the good scraggers for Collingwood, Dimatina, who gets a job each week. And... does pretty well, Dimatina, at trying to restrict the opposition, and And Greg Tivendale has had Dimitana removed on his second opponent now. Floating down. He's pretty dangerous, that boy. Look, centre breaks are going in Collingwood's favour. 10-3.
Let's have a look at this Shepherd off the play as Tivendale ran down. What do you reckon, boys?
Yeah, a bit of an act on it, but worth a look at. I reckon he probably didn't make enough of an attempt to go the man, the ball carrier.
Back in the centre of the ground. Obviously, the Magpies need to get a couple to get back anywhere near this game. The Tigers are all over the Pies at the moment. 37 points the difference. And here go the Tigers again. It spills out to Knights. Knights looks up, kicks it long. Clement is the man against Otten. Does well, Clement. There's Holland, in fact, fighting for the ball. Clement still goes. Umpire calls play on. James Clement kicks it out wide. And a beautiful mark taken there by Jason Tawney in front of Richard Colony's first game tonight. Tawney concedes ground to Cameron, who's a beautiful setup of the ball. He kicks it up, looking and finding Ottens. The Twin Towers are taking Collingwood to the cleaners tonight. The 10-minute mark of the second term. Ottens will line up for the Tigers' 12th goal.
And it's just the script is running perfectly from a Richmond point of view, and it's probably the way that you'd think it would pan out. Anthony Rocker just can't get back into that hole. I mean, he's trying to sit back there and help out with the big fellas, but he can't get there. And there's too much time and space through the midfield for the Richmond boys to deliver. And these blokes are in pretty rare marking form.
Third mark for Brad Ottens for the evening. 78% probability from this spot from the last 4 years of football for Brad Ottens, who made his debut back in 1998. He comes in for his second goal and for the Tigers' 12th. 37 points the difference. It is now 43 points the difference, and the Tigers are starting to massacre the Magpies at the MCG.
They're just falling down with big men, and their little men now are starting to follow suit. They just haven't got enough big men at the moment, Collingwood. They're getting... You made the call before about Stafford. I know he's not doing anything at the moment, but his presence, and then you get on the end, Richardson up forward. You've got this fella pushing forward.
Right,
and
there,
now they've got
Sorry
Ben
to
Holland.
Jump in. Right there, that is what Stafford's doing. He might not be getting that much of the footy, but he's allowing that bloke to stay around. That other guy who's got 12 on his back. And he might be the recruit of the year, Stafford, if he could stand up.
So many targets for the Tigers up forward. 12-2, plays 5-1. Rocker had to wait for the bouncing ball. Bowden, nicely done. Gaspar peeling off, kicks it down towards half forward. Here comes Richardson, unkind bounce, freeborn, slaps it back towards his defensive goal. Burns under the pump, slips it away. Freeborn in space, that's better, but Theorist lays it off. Johnson breaks from half back, kicks to half forward, storming up the ground. Down there is Rintoul, had it knocked away by Zantac. The crumb falls to Knights. Fiora. Rebound opportunity here for the Tigers. Stafford, the man Gary was talking about, pushes off Rocker, kicks to centre half forward. The ball hangs a long time in the air. Freeborn couldn't hang on. Well done by Richardson. Freeborn's quick hands away. Too slick. Cameron now inside the 50. Comes back to Houlihan, just outside the 50. Well, look at this. All the time in the world. Kicks it down towards the kickoff line. Slapped away by Presta Giacomo. All Tigers in front. If he can stand up, Ottens. Well, he was stumbling. It's a behind.
It was a long way down to the ground for that fella, wasn't it?
But again, without wanting to harp, Brad Ottens is 6'7", is the first one in to win a crumb. And there was time. Houlihan danced around there for 5 minutes.
Maggie's a shell-shocked at the moment. The skipper's got it. Needs to lift and lead from the front. Scotland to Lucuria. Must hit a target. Goes wide out. There's... lacking a bit of confidence there as Betheris took off and then had to go back and kick around the corner with the left foot. Tawney holds his spot and takes the mark. Umpire says play on, and the Tigers are lined up again. Here they go. It's like a rugby league run here. Look at this. Knights out wide. There's two of them. Kellaway can give it away to Zilla. Holds his spot. Chips it forward. Cracker. Well, he just watched it in the end. Just lost sight of it. And luckily for Collingwood, Clement was there. Here's Buckley.
It's a clockwise football match at the moment. The ball goes towards the outer side. Tarrant's got it.
Circle work, Dennis.
Amazing, isn't it? One side is dominant. 75-31. Tarrant, high ball down towards half forward. Rocker in front. Good mark.
This is what they need, Dennis. They need a dominant player at half forward.
That was untidy. At the feet of Davis, kicks to the pocket. Rintoul on the lead. Thought about going, flirted with it, didn't. The umpire insisting that Zantuck come back on the mark.
You get one mark, one contested mark from a player playing true centre half forward for Collingwood, and somehow they get a shot at goal. They haven't had that all night, a contested mark at half forward.
Not exactly position A. Rintoul slides it across the face. Cummings missed it, and the ball is across the line for a behind, despite what you're seeing here. Tawney and Cummings going at it. Got unhappy about something. Meantime, play has passed them by as it comes out towards the wing. Hurlihan off his fingertips, taken away by Lockyer. Boots it back. He's got a sense of humour. Back towards where they were fighting, and Tarrant's been paid a mark. Well, barely held it long enough.
That was there, Dennis. He actually made contact with him. I know it's only light. And
so he's paid the free, has he?
Yeah, and it's not a big, you know, impost on the player going for the ball. But if you watch the player, watch him here, and he watches the player, not the ball, and makes contact. You make any contact when you do nothing but watch the player, you're gone.
Tarrant kicks and brushes the post, I fancy. And behind, they can't catch a break.
Well, they do lack confidence in their half forwards. Struggling in the Richmond halfbacks, on the other hand, super confident. So when the ball goes inside Collingwood's forward 50, they think they're a fair chance of winning the ball, and the attack forward is overwhelming.
Outside 50. This is the first time, I reckon, for the game, boys, that Collingwood have had it in their forward line for any space of time. And we'll have a throw in. 60 metres outside the Collingwood goal, 75 to 33, as you can see on the screen. We've played 15 and a half. Out it comes to Buckley from 55. He slices the ball up in the air. Nick Davis is the man for Collingwood, who flies off the hands of the pack. It falls to Cummings, pushing the back surely. And they get one, and the Collingwood fans go up, because it has been 10-3, and as you can see there, Justin Smith with a sense of humour saying to Scotty Cummings, it's all yours, son.
He's playing in front. His team's getting blown to bits, but he's the only bloke who's playing in front. He's a big body, and when you've got that bigger backside and shoulders, you block out the view for the player coming from behind, and they're forced to tackle you.
Scotty Cummings will line up for goal number four for the night.
In the most polite way, I mean, he's got the big backside and shoulders, but he's a good kick, and he shouldn't have too much problem here. We'll have a look at it.
No need to say that this is a vital, important kick for the Collingwood team tonight. Kicked 346 career goals, Scott Cummings, in his 123 games of football. He lines up to the city end. Scott Cummings kicks and kicks goal number four, if you believe the cheer squad, but the umpire says it's a point.
With a slice.
So nothing going right for the Magpies. Two shots at goal from their key forwards, Cummings and also Tarrant, have resulted in just two behinds when two goals were desperately needed. Tigers are 12-3-75. Collingwood are 5-4-34.
Scott Cummings justifying the gamble. Looking dangerous on the forward line. One of the very few. This is Rogers. Got it from Fiora. Hugs the boundary line to King. Comes back towards the middle. Plenty of Tigers. Not 15's the call. Tivendale goes across the ground. Hall unloads. Long bomb down towards half forward. It'll pitch in no man's land and run on. Ottens, was it in the back? Not according to the umpire, who was perfectly placed. The free kick is now going to Collingwood. Tiger fans are happy with it. And obviously, so is Ottens. Burns. This is Freeborn, out of the back pocket. Nobody to kick to. Nobody running hard, creating further afield. Frustrated, he goes for distance. Two-on-one situation. Well, that really was a kick born out of frustration. Richardson's got it on the wing.
You just need the half-forward to read that, Dennis, and come up and be just offer something.
But you can't just kick it there, can you?
No.
I mean, it was almost giving up. The ball back at the 50. Trying to work it through was Rocker, chopped off by King, down towards full forward, up in front, Houlihan. That was Hilton cruising past. Houlihan beat three of them, got it across to Zilla. Not notorious for his goal kicking, got some height on that one. They fumble a couple of players down there, Clement and Buckley. Lecuria on his knees, tackled by Hilton. He concedes a behind.
Great effort down there by Houlihan. He's effectively playing full forward at the moment, and they all know their responsibilities, these Richmond blokes, so they do tonight. That is contest hard, bring the ball to the front if they can't mark it.
Wayne Campbell having a massage and an extended half-time break as Collingwood get the ball up to centre wing. Rintoul's been good tonight for the Pies and takes a mark. Handball's on. Here's Betheris. Dumps it inside 50. Looking for Cummings. Hard for him when it hits the ground. Ray Hall's there for the Tigers. Cummings goes again over the top looking for the free kick. Knights has got it. He's caught. He threw it away. And the umpire says throw it in. Boundary. And it'll be a throw in about 35 metres out from the Collingwood goal. We've played 19 and a quarter in this, the second term. There's the top five disposals. Buckley's got 12, Tawney 10 and Tivendale. Betheris 9 and Knights 9. Throw in. Lucuria trying to get the handball out. Davis paddles it forward. Tries again. Davis! Davis! Goal!
Well, the ability to make something out of nothing, which is unique to someone like Leon Davis, Ronnie Burns, Jeff Farmer, those sorts of fellows who just are able to get a handle ball, tap it into space, really, against Darren Gasper there. And again, even when he got
pace
tackled, had the presence of mind just to get it onto the boot.
The pace did it, didn't it? Because Gasper, sensing it was young Davis, knew that he wasn't going to match him, so he made a final lunge, lost his feet. He was out of the contest when the ball stayed alive.
Wonderful perseverance by Leon Davis, particularly when you consider the quality of the opposition. Darren Gaspar there step for step, and suddenly Davis manufacturing a goal. Bowden getting busy. High ball, floating it out towards the wing. Roden on the ground, kept out of the contest. Flying high was Scotland, sliding in with courage. King lays it off to Houlihan, kicks inside the 50. Going back, Wichow!
Well, at that bounce down, Dennis, there were seven Collingwood backmen, and Richmond ran another player forward to match him up. So they played seven forwards from the bounce down, the Tigers.
50 metres.
It's, which Collingwood player is going to ask what it was for, and we might get an answer. He's having a night, Richo. Seventh mark, Dermot. We saw him in the... Is that an explanation?
He's doing it himself.
Probability, I haven't got the figures, but I know it's good. Richardson, point-blank range, gets his fifth.
Well, you saw Matthew Richardson in the Wizard Home Loans Cup Grand Final, and he wasn't great. He had a pretty dirty night, to be honest, and couldn't get a break to go his way there. He's behind, ball falls over the back, he sticks one mid up, able to stay in the area and take a mark. So he's enjoying the night. He could end up with 10.
Welcome back. Matthew Richardson has 5 goals with 5 and 43 seconds remaining on the clock in this second term. The Tigers 13-4, Collingwood 6-4. It's 7 goals the difference. 42 points back in the centre. Otten's in the ruck for the Tigers. Rocker goes up. It comes down to Scotland. Scotland gets the kick away up to the forward line. It bounces awkwardly for Holland. Probably should have gone harder at the ball on that occasion. And the defensive kick finds the boundary line right on centre wing. Will have a throw in.
Dermot, good coaching by Danny Foley. 7-man forward line, Richmond winning. They aren't prepared to let Collingwood drop a loose player back on Richardson.
Well, every time the ball goes in there, we've seen it's a one-on-one at least.
Otten's versus Buckley, the two number fives. And as you can see, it was Ottens who got it away. Holland on hands and knees, knocks it out to Johnson. Over the top of the ball. It's locked up beautifully there by Jason Tawney. We'll have another bounce. Half-forward flank for the Magpies.
Ed, what's the story with Heath Scotland? I must bring out the best in him. Every time I see him play, plays well. He's come on. He's picked up possessions here.
He's had osteitis pubis for probably the last 12 months and has an interrupted summer again, has only played last week for the first time for the Williamstown side. So he comes in with Rocker and also Fraser without much preparation into this campaign and starting to show.
I've got this theory, when in doubt, pick a country. So we've got this bounce down towards left half forward.
Get Andrew Ireland back, you reckon?
That's right. 13-4, players 6-4. Approaching half time. Ottens goes up, slaps it wide. Shepherding. And there's going to be a free kick to the Magpies.
Why would they shepherd when they got Brad Ottens against Nathan Buckley in the ruck?
They're footballers. Buckley kicks inside the 50. And a good mark is taken by Otten's, keen to make amends, drifting back into the hole, swings it out wide. Well, too wide as it turns out. Fiora was headed off in a different direction. Davis decides to take him on close to the boundary line. Davis finessing. Fiora put him down. The cavalry arrived. King got a hand pass to Richardson. Richardson goes back towards the middle. This is Tawny. He's been very good. Lays it off to Campbell. Good shepherd it was too. Across the ground. Opportunity building here. Kellaway twists away. Comes towards the middle. Taken by Houlihan. Spots a man. Two on one situation. They can cram it out there. It's three on two. Opportunity for Campbell. Gathers it. Goes in short, marked in the hands by Holland, about 55 metres out.
Bowden's got Rocky, he's going to lead him off his legs here, if he can get up the ground.
Instead, he comes to Otten's, 55 metres still from goal.
Well drilled in as much that they know the opposition ruckman's dropping back in the hole. They won't just blast away, they're prepared to move it round the field like, it's almost like chess, just the way they move from side to side till they get it into the hands of someone who's capable. And this bloke's capable from outside 50.
That's what we're looking at, down the spine of the ground.
I'd take the odds on that, Dermot, 34%.
With this bloke, you would.
5 marks for Brad Ottens. Goes in short after all of that. They were thinking like we were. Queuing up to take the odds, and Tawny just queued up, and now will shoot at goal from about 35 metres out.
Gee, you'd be filthy about that if you were Mick Malthouse.
He's an emerging player, Jason Tawny.
He's good, isn't he?
Yeah.
I'm very impressed with him the last couple of years. He's always had reasonable pace. 13th disposal, 5th mark. And a shot on goal. Playing in the back pocket tonight, he's just pushed forward at this occasion because the ball's been down in the forward line so much, and Houlihan coming off with the blood rule.
What does it say when there's a stop in play? Ottens has had the ball in his hand outside 50, probably for 20 seconds, and Tawny's allowed to just wander in there and mark uncontested.
Basic safety is always, they haven't got more out there than you. The basic safety is know where your opponent is.
They're switched off, that's what that it says.
Tawny, 35 metres out, gives it a ride. It's touch and go. He's missed. But it does stretch the lead close to half-time.
13-5-83. That's Richmond. Collingwood 6-4-40. The margin is 43 points. 26 minutes gone in this, the second term. Collingwood goes short and dangerous. Nothing coming off, not even the set plays. Here's Freeborn close to the boundary line to press the Giacomo over the top to Tarkin Lockyer. Davis is the man. Needs to mark it. Keeps it in front of him though. Buckley shepherds well. Here's Davis dancing around. Onto the boot. Up towards Holland. Close to the boundary line. And over it goes for another throw in. But Leon Davis having a go tonight. No doubt about that. Trying to manufacture something. 6 possessions for the night for Magic. Throw in Anthony Rocker. And Ottens. Ottens taps it to Knights. Rocker does the work, does it well, well. Gets a little handball going. Buckley trying to push it forward. In goes Campbell. Over the top's Betheris. We'll have another ball up.
There comes a time in your career, I reckon, when you've got all the ability like Anthony Rocker and you can do the special things, but there comes a time when you lose that tiny bit of youth and you have to turn yourself into a battering ram, a bang crash type player, and that's what Anthony Rocker did then. And he's only moved the ball forward 20, 30 metres, but to their advantage.
Scramble after it, standing up in the tackle, Bowden. Hurriedly, Lucuria kicks it down towards the pocket, keeping it in Tarrant. Well done, back to Holland. Open goal beckons. Can he go with the reverse? He can. A belated goal close to half time for the Magpies, but they'll take what they can get. 83 plays 46.
Well, they've worked it pretty well there, and the forward, the Collingwood forward, I think it was Scotty Cummings, he just peeled off the back. He was smart because he knew that Brodie Holland was going to draw the player towards him. A lot of players would gravitate to the goal line. You watch it here. As he gets closer, Scotty Cummings peels out the back. And there he is. See, he's gone to just open up the angle a bit, but Holland decided for the direct shot himself. Want a few more on the board before you start pumping the air?
It's a start, though, for Brodie Holland. He gets his first goal of the game. 28 minutes gone in this, the second term. A minute and a half on the scoreboard. Well, the Tigers got one with 2 seconds to go in the first term. What will happen in the last minute and a half of this? It's very important for the Magpies to get it going forward, but it's Campbell for the Tigers who gets it out of the centre. Here's Clement for Collingwood. He handballs out to Burns. Burns has got an option up forward. It's Dimatina. He sits and waits and takes the ball. Good play by Knights. It bounced off his chest. Here's Scotland for Collingwood. To Johnson on his left boot. Looks forward. Cummings comes at him. Has to stand his ground. And in the meantime, Ottens gets back and takes the mark. That is well-drilled football.
Absolutely. You saw Ray Hall just put the body pressure on Cummings, making sure he wasn't able to run out and apply pressure to the dropping back Ottens.
Total disposals, Richmond 142 to Collingwood's 117. And of course their marks are miles in front of Collingwood as well. So they're using it beautifully as Callaway takes the ball up. With seconds remaining in this quarter, this could be the last roll of the dice for the Magpies. As Rocket to Freeborn, Freeborn to Scotland. They're close on the boundary line. Burns wants it in the corridor and gets it. Takes the mark. Too far out to score. Needs something. A wall of Tigers is there. He goes short and Holland's got it.
This is where Anthony Rocker needs to just amble up. He's just out of screen here on the left. He just needs to amble up, get side on, and sneak a pretty easy one here.
There it is, Brody, all right?
So Brody Holland, who punched the air just moments ago as he kicked his first, lines up with an AFL average of 25% from 47 metres and 34 degrees.
Over the last 4 years, Ed, those statistics, so that's a little bit surprising from that range.
Well, we've got a reverse angle shot here as Holland lines up to the city end. And ride this one home.
Yeah, you're right, mate.
Six disposal for Brody Holland, his third mark. He kicked the goal, banana on the run. This the set shot. He comes in from 52 metres. He gives it a good kick at the goal, but he's hooked it trying to find the extra distance, and it's through for just one behind. Collingwood now move on to 7-5-47. Richmond 13-5-83. The margin is six goals.
You watch this kick in here. Richmond will probably put only one player out to the other side, so it's going to come out up the middle. So they spread the zone here. Nearly every other Richmond player is on this side of the ground.
Exactly. Siren. That's what I was going to say, Dennis. The siren is due.
And due it is. That was the last shot for Collingwood from Brody Holland. It was a point, and the Tigers go off after their first half of football in season 2002, and it is all their way at the moment. The Tigers, 13-5-83, lead Collingwood 7-5-47. They lead by 36 points at halftime. Richardson has kicked five goals to halftime, three goals to Greg Tivendale, two goals to Brad Ottens, and singles to Gasper and Cracker. For Collingwood, Scott Cummings has kicked three goals and singles to Leon Davis, Richardson, Holland, and Chad Rintoul.